you so much for joining us for today's availability. We have Coach John
Recording
Harbaugh
in progress.
Just as a quick reminder, if you can utilize the raise hand function to ask a question, we'll be happy to call on you. We'll get it started with opening it up to Coach.
All right, good to see everybody. Appreciate you coming on Zoom to do the press conference. We're excited about a big game, obviously against an excellent opponent with a lot at stake. And proud of our guys. The work ethic has been tremendous, and we're just preparing for the game. What questions do you have?
We'll get it started with Jameson Hensley.
Hey, John, what can you tell us about Lamar, and do you expect him to be at practice today?
I really don't have any updates on that. That's wait and see for all those guys. I mean, every single guy you're about to ask me about is all going to be day by day, and we'll just see where they're at as we go.
Todd Karpovich.
Hey, Coach, when you go back and look at that Bengals game the last time you played in Baltimore, so you guys struggled with the tackling a little bit in that game. How much have you cleaned it up since that game, and how big of a difference will that make in this game as far as, you know, stopping them?
It's going to be very important. Tackling is critical. Many of their yards are catch-and-run yards. Many of their rushing yards are yards after contact. Many of their big plays are yards after the catch. So we've got to do a great job of tackling, of course.
Hey, Coach, good to see you. Jamar Chase obviously had a monster game last time. How do you, the big plays, though, you guys really kind of shrunken down a lot lately, the last several games. How do you attribute that, and what as far as applying that to then?
It's just a matter of playing disciplined football, Pete. You know, we've got to play disciplined football. We've got to have our eyes in the right spot. We've got to take good angles, and we got to wrap up and get them on the ground. These are good run after the catch players. All these guys, including Jamar, as you mentioned, but not just Jamar. I mean, Tyler Boyd's good at it. T. Higgins is good at it. Azuma's good at it. One of the most underrated tight ends in the league is Azuma. So, yeah, these guys are all talented guys. We're going to have to do a great job, and I expect that we will.
Childs Walker.
You're on mute, Childs.
All right, we'll go to Jerry Coleman.
He's back. Childs is back. He got it. He figured it out.
Sorry, John. I'm out of practice. I was just saying, you talked about the stakes of the game just as you did on Monday. I know you approach every week with urgency. Is there a do-or-die quality to this one, maybe more than any of the previous games this year just because of the standings?
We just, you put anybody can put whatever label on it they want. That's really not my mission, to put labels on it and name it with any particular phrase.
Jerry Coleman.
Hey, Coach. I believe it was the last time you guys were out on the road. There were a lot of pre-snap offensive penalties. Is that something you're working on for this week, knowing that since he's going to be amped up, they're talking about this being the biggest crowd they've had since their last playoff game?
Yeah, we're going to work really hard at that. Absolutely. That's very important.
David Andrade.
Hello, Coach. Can you give us an update, and how do you see the performance of Tony Jefferson? I know it's going to be a big role for him with this weekend, but can you tell us about him?
Tony just came last week. He was in very good shape, as the workout showed us. He has a good familiarity with the defense, and that was nice to see. He hadn't really lost any of his understanding of it. Picked up the new things really quickly. Played well in the game, the snaps that he played, both on defense and special teams. So, Tony's role will be what it is based on who we have, and I expect him to play very well.
Cordell Woodland.
Hey, Coach. You guys just had to play this game against Green Bay pretty shorthanded in the secondary. With the chances that you may have to do that again this week, how much confidence did that game give you in this secondary going up against a loaded Bengals receiving group?
Right. Well, I think it's pretty well understood that we have confidence in our players. We trust our guys. They're at practice every day. They work hard. They learn the defense. There's still many things in that game that we can do better in the back end. Leverages, eyes, assignments, communication, just basic technique that we can do better. So we'll keep chasing that. We coach all of our guys all the time. We'll keep coaching those guys to play better and better. and see if some of these guys can make a name for themselves.
Coach,
The Bengals seem to have been running the ball particularly well, but then the last 3 weeks they have not done so well at that. Are there any trends that you're noticing or anything you can exploit right there? And when you look at the Bengals run game, what stands out?
Well, I mean, what stands out is the running back. I mean, you know, Mixon is one of the best in the league. If you know, I don't think there's a better running back in the league than him. He runs hard. He's powerful. He's got great lateral quickness, body control. He can catch the ball. They use him quite a bit as a receiver. He's very good in pass protection. I mean, all those things. You know, then Sam J. Perrin is also, he's a power back, downhill guy, good cutback runner. You know, hard to bring down. It's a great lower body runner. So, you know, it starts with those two guys. They run the wide zone play exceptionally well. That's their basis. They always got some scheme runs, especially in the red zone. They love to run the ball in the red zone. That's kind of their thing. And then you got to take care of Joe Burrow, because Joe Burrow gets yards. You know, he'll slip out of the pocket and go get some yards for him too, or he'll slip out and throw it, a lot of times deep. So, you know, that kind of accounts for, I think, their rushing yards, and you've got to do a good job defending it. You've got to hold the edges. We've got to, you know, our linebackers, we've got to pace the play very well, especially the zone play. But if we do those things, we've been defending the run well of late, and I'm very confident that we can do a good job of that.
We'll close it out here with Jameson Hensley.
John, do you know if you've had any more positive tests today? And what's the level of concern with, it looks like now the outside linebacker position is getting hit as well. What's your level of concern as far as depth at outside linebacker?
Yeah, all those things are just in the protocol, Jameson. It's really not for commentary. It is what it is. I mean, the protocols are what they are. The days, the testing, all that stuff, it's kind of complicated. I don't spend too much time with it. So it is what it is, and we'll be where we're at, and we're getting ready for practice right now.
Coach, we appreciate you joining us today. Thank you so much.
All right, thanks, everybody. Appreciate seeing you guys. Have a good one.